And we've all watched a lot of wedding marches, a lot of brides and grooms entering in various fashions. I promise you, this is something you would not have seen. A lot of hard work is put in, not only for them, but also for you guys to have fun and celebrate along with them. And before we start, I want to know if you guys are ready.
Yes!
These hard work is put in, then I'll be ready.
Yes!
Are you ready?
Yes!
3, 2, Lenny always rides the bike and Eddy sits behind. So it works like that in their relationship as well. So she drives the relationship basically. So that's what I... Before that, when we had all said, what if she says no? You know what Eddy actually told us? Man, she'll fall at my feet and say, please marry me. He actually said this. We have people who can vouch for this. Pretty good listener. So there is this very famous bar called Brigitte Prince right outside our college, St. Joseph's. Yeah, so all these guys know. He's a very good listener. He's heard more than half the college's problems over there. And including the bartender's problems. So he's a very good financial planner. I've heard this from PUC. I've not seen this, but I've heard that once when two of his friends gave him a cigarette which was King's, which costed 5 rupees. He went back and he exchanged it for 2 cigarettes of 2 rupees 50 paisa. So, Lenny, don't worry about your money.
Making up those wonderful stories. I still remember the day as if it was yesterday. You know, the 20th of December 2012. The day I went down on 2 knees and I begged my mom and dad to pay for my wedding. distinguished guests with a lot of distinction, guests with no distinction at all. Family, friends, young and old, in-laws, outlaws, friends and colleagues, and anybody else who might have wandered in. On behalf of my wife and I, when I would like to refer to her as my most recent ex-girlfriend, would like to welcome you for our reception. I have Lenny's mom, Auntie Sybil. Auntie, I congratulate you for raising such a caring, independent, loving daughter. I feel like I've known her forever. I thank you for giving her away so willingly. Lenny is in good hands now. And I promise that I will do my best to make sure she takes good care of me. Okay, on a serious note, and I promise that I will always love and protect her. She is the love of my life, and I hope today that you have not lost a daughter, but gained an extra seat at the dinner table. As we both know that Lenny is a bad cook. Next, my mom and dad. June and April. First time I'm calling them by name, by the way. I thank you, Mom and Dad, for always being there for me, for bringing up such a talented, successful and independent son. Thank you for everything that you have done for me, and I want to apologize for everything I've done to you all. Okay, you put up with me for 26 years and loved and supported me in every way possible. You have sacrificed so much of your life to give me the best possible start, and I couldn't have asked God for greater parents. I hope that I made you proud. Philip, my brother, my partner in crime, I think together we guys have been double the trouble for Mom and Dad. Well, Phil and I have fond memories together, and I want Philip to know how happy I am to have you as a brother. Life would never be the same without you. Cheers, bro. I would like to give a toast to our parents, to express the gratitude that, and the support, general support they have shared with us throughout this wedding preparation. Without them, none of this would have been possible, or for that matter, a poor wedding. So, cheers to the family.
It comes with no surprise, I always like to have the last word today. And the first and biggest thank you is to everyone who's come here today and made our day so special. I have to mention of my mom and dad. I want to thank both mom and dad for shaping me to the person I am today. They have gained another set of parents, my in-laws. I wouldn't call them in-laws. But Auntie June, my teacher from the first standard, so I've known her for so long. And Uncle, I've seen him in church, I think, I'm most importantly shouting at Philip and Eddy all the time. But I'm so happy that I've been welcomed so warmly into your family. And thank you for raising Eddy for the horrible brat he is today, that I have to have so much of patience to put up with him. But he is a gem and the most humble man I've met in my life. I know she said so many prayers that I found such a wonderful man in my life. Eddy.